Archroma presents The Indigo in Your Jeans. The blue dye in your jeans is called indigo. Indigo is a pigment that used to be extracted from plants. Due to the inefficiencies in plant extraction and advances in organic chemistry, indigo was first commercially synthesized in 1897 out of coal tar. Current manufacture is still based on similar chemistry. But have you ever wondered why the indigo in your jeans gets washed out over time? Sam certainly has. Some of the indigo in his darker jeans has rubbed off on his sneakers, and sometimes even on his hands. To uncover this blue mystery, he asks his friend Cheryl, who manages a clothing store. She tells Sam how jeans are made. Indigo is special. Unlike most other colors, it is not water-soluble. To allow it to dye cotton, indigo pigment goes through a reduction process, either with other chemicals or hydrogen gas, to form a water-soluble green dye. Yarn is dipped into this green dye, then taken out and exposed to air, which oxidizes it and turns it back into its insoluble form, an indigo blue in color. Each time it is dipped, more layers of indigo are built up onto the surface of the yarn. Due to the oxidation process, the color indigo is locked into the fibers. But when this happens, some impurities also get trapped inside the oxidized insoluble indigo. The indigo yarn is then woven, made into jeans, and laundered. When some of the indigo layers get washed out, it gives denim its individual look, which is why some people feel that their vintage jeans look unique. Sam realizes that his experience with his jeans is just some of these indigo layers coming off. However, he is curious about the impurities Cheryl mentioned. Cheryl says that the main impurity is called aniline. Though it is currently an essential raw material for the manufacture of indigo dye, it is a classified substance and is also harmful to the environment and aquatic life. Why is this important? Well, billions of blue jeans are made every year, resulting in over 400 metric tons of aniline as waste. That would fill over 5,000 bathtubs. More than two-thirds of this ends up in the environment. The rest ends up on the fabric. Sam is a little concerned, as he and his friends wear jeans every day, and he doesn't want to put the environment at risk. This is why Archroma is taking a precautionary approach, innovating processes to bring to the market indigo without aniline, so that upon application, it is as clean as natural indigo from the past, but without all the inefficiencies and problems that come with growing it. If it's not there in the first place, we won't have any worries. Sam and Cheryl would definitely prefer to be wearing jeans that haven't polluted the environment. They both look forward to a cleaner and safer indigo for their jeans, the environment, and the planet. Aniline-free. Archroma. It's our nature.